Hello there, good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London. It is about 1 o'clock in the afternoon here in the capital, and those votes are still being counted. It's Friday, November 6th, and we still don't know who will be the next president of the United States. Will it remain Donald Trump, or will it be a new one, Joe Biden? We're not entirely sure this week, but we have been watching those markets and seeing the tech stocks rising, the likes of Facebook, Apple, Alphabet, all gaining. We've got our Richard Jeans with us here, our tech expert here at Proactive London. Richard, what a week!
Yes, good afternoon, Katie. While we still don't know the results of the US election, it is increasingly looking like a gridlock with Democrats in the White House and the Republican Senate. Yes. From an investor's perspective, this is favourable as the White House will struggle to put through any radical changes. Meanwhile, the ongoing lockdowns on this side of the pond add extra impetus in their drive to the digital channel.
Absolutely. We mentioned lockdown. Of course, we're on our second day here in England, and there are so many factors to talk about there. But I just want to maybe talk about one of those tech stocks. It's been a huge story this morning. Aveva, they've announced this multi-billion rights issue to fund OSIsoft. Talk us through this, Richard.
Yes, Aveva provides engineering and industrial software, has announced the terms of its £2.8 billion rights issue to finance the acquisition of OSIsoft. The rights issue should help it leapfrog FTSE software peer Sage in the market capitalization rankings, making it number one in the UK software. Aveva's interim results showed a 15% decline in revenue and a 38% fall in adjusted EBIT. However, it says that the order pipeline is strong, but this is largely due to increased contract renewals as well as contracts that slipped from the first half.
Mm-hmm. Seeing Machines, I saw this week that they delivered higher full-year revenues, right?
Yes, Seeing Machines provides operator monitoring systems to improve transport safety. It grew annual revenues by 25.5% to $40 million Australian dollars. The company has spent some two decades investing in its product. And the OEM business is only really beginning to take off. It is also broadening the functionality from driver monitoring systems to occupant monitoring systems, which can be useful, for example, in child detection.
Oh, wow. Okay. Very interesting indeed. There were two positive trading updates that I know we're going to talk through today, D4T4 and PCI Pal.
Yes, that's right. D4T4, the data solutions provider, announced four new contract wins, which will add a total of around £5.5 million to revenue in the current financial year. These wins suggest the group's strategy is working. PCI Pal, meanwhile, the secure payment solutions provider, said in its AGM trading update that it has made a strong start to the current year, with first quarter revenues 44% ahead of last year, and 88% of revenues in the year to June 2021 are already in the bag.
Excellent. Richard, crystal ball time. What are you looking at next week? What's your tip?
Well, actually, next week is another relatively quiet week in UK corporate results. We've got Zoo Digital, which provides a cloud-based localization and digital distribution services for the global entertainment industry, reporting reports interim results on Tuesday. In its AGM update in September, it said it expected to report double-digit revenue growth in the six-month period.
Excellent. Richard, thank you very much indeed. You say sort of a quiet time in the corporate world, but certainly not in the political world. I'm really excited to see what's going to unfold next week. Richard Jeans, Proactive London's tech expert. Thank you very much indeed.
Okay. Thank you, Katie.